like by some fire. But 15, 20 minutes later, the Turks had showed up here, and by then only one steeple, and that's the southern one, got finished. Yeah, the northern one stayed unfinished. Yeah, and the southern one is 450 feet in height altogether. Yeah, and you can climb 300 feet. And this is where my family comes in now, because it was my grandpa's brother who was a stonemason. And in history, stonemasons were the first pioneers. Because he was a stonemason who worked all the job. He did never have a task. Later on, he got a different meaning. So my grandfather's brother was a stonemason, a Freemason, and that means he, together with two companions, restored the pulpit of St. Stephen's. So I always say we have a connection this way, but I'm working hard on getting it back.
Thank you. Well, I mean, on this one, there are plan Bs to get back.
Yeah.
So, not quite as bad as some others. Just the cathedral, I mean the sign.
My son's been here also.
Amazing. Too bad we didn't get to go in there.
Well, you could have.
I love it, really does.
But on a Sunday, it's going to be so crowded.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there wouldn't have been time to.
Right.
Yeah, this would have been rushed. My history would have been rushed.
But today's going to be a pretty rush like this. They're just going to have to fight out there, but
MGM. That's the same store they had in Prague.
Second leg in, shovel and shovel, you know? But finally he made it. He got the dog into the car.
They're like humans.
They
definitely
have a opinion. Where?
Well, this is charming. McDonald's.
Oh yeah. Again.
Look at these nice little cafes down here and everything.
Passes hours.
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
modern construction you can see here. Very often I'm asked, what is that ship doing here? Well, it just looks like a ship. It has the shape of one, but basically it's a harbor. And you can see from here the speedboats, the catamarans, are leaving from here, going all the way to Bratislava. Bratislava, the capital town of Slovakia. Those are the two nearest located capital towns you find here in Europe, basically. Except if you think about Italy. There is one capital town located in another one, because the Vatican is a totally independent state, and it's located in the capital town, Rome. Yeah? So it's part of it. And we are down here going parallel to Danube Canal, and there's hundreds of little pubs and bars and restaurants down here where the temperature is extremely high, you know, in a lot of the old buildings they don't have air conditioning, and that's a very, very serious problem for the people living there. So our decision is, in the evening, if you don't have an air-conditioned apartment, you never go home after work immediately, but you go to the restaurants, to the coffee houses down here, you sit here, you chatter, you meet your friends, you meet your neighbors, you drink something, you eat something, and then around 11 p.m. you finally find your way back home. And that's why the whole territory here is called the summer stage. It's like a beach area in the city, but the only section you can swim in comes up on the left hand side, remember, the bluely colored swimming pool. Yeah? And on the right hand side, that's the beginning of Ring Boulevard. We started there earlier. Left hand side, that building, Urania, at the end of it, you find a tower with a cupola, and that's the observatory of our city. And to the right hand side, bridge crossing, and you see the river Veen showing up here. At the moment, it's more like a creek than a river at all. And we are going parallel now to the banks of the Danube Canal. And one of the things I'm very often asked about is, all the graffiti you see on the walls over there, is that legally done, yes or no? The answer is simple, yes. Yeah? This is legally done. It's students of art. Yeah? And our politicians, they said, you know, if we hand over certain areas to young people to do that type of art, then they hopefully won't demolish or won't damage our regular apartment houses. And it worked out pretty well, because when we walked the streets of downtown Vienna, of the first district, did you see any graffiti at all?
No.
No way, right? Yeah? Somewhere in the districts around here, you might find it. And if we catch somebody doing that, yeah, he has to pay a fine, and he has to pay for the repainting of the damage he had done, yeah, to get rid of it. And if he cannot do that, they even put him into prison. We had that happening about half a year ago. The guy was sent to prison for 3 months. Yeah? And now he's back at his job, and he decorated 70 entrance doors of houses. Yeah? And now each month he has to pay for the repainting of one of the entrance doors. Yeah? So I think he's never going to do graffiti in his whole life anymore. Yeah? Whereas down here, as I said, it's legally along the banks of the Danube Canal. And as they are students of art, very often the professors come along here and they ask you, what is the stuff you painted on the wall? So they have to tell you exactly what it is. And to give an idea about it, for instance, last year there was a cute scene sprayed on the wall. It was the princess holding the frog in her hand. Yeah? And I'm sure you're familiar with the fairy tale. When you kiss the frog, he turns into a prince. Yeah? And so everybody knows that fairy tale. And 2 weeks later, when I came by here a second time, I couldn't believe my eyes, because there was a school class sitting in front of that down there. The teacher told them the fairy tale, and then the kids started to write and continue the story. They had a happy married life, they had so and so many kids, or they didn't get along well with each other, they had a divorce. Yeah? Everything was possible. Whatever the kids wanted to do, they could do. And I think that's a great thing to educate kids, not only teach them in school indoors, but take them outdoors and also do excursions. And one of the locations for excursions is down near the Prater. If you look down to the right hand side, you can see that long, long alley now. That's 3.5 miles. It's as long as the Ring Boulevard, but it goes straight from the Ferris wheel here all the way down to the former hunting lodge of the Habsburgs. And this is different to amusement parks like in the United States, yeah? When I've been Disneyland and so on, you had to pay an entrance fee, yeah? And that included more or less all the rides, yeah? You didn't have to pay for any of the rides, but the entrance fee was pretty high. Here it goes the other way around. Everybody gets a chance to come to the amusement park just to stroll around, and for each of the rides you're taking, you pay. Yeah, for bumper cars, roller coasters, merry-go-rounds, or like a tour on the Ferris wheel is like roughly around €9. And to give you an idea, the Prater itself goes from here all the way down to the banks of the Danube River, more or less. Yeah? So just to compare it, it's twice the size of Central, 4 times the size of Hyde Park in London. Yeah? So no wonder they call it the green lungs in our city. And around the Ferris wheel, there you have the fair, which means you have the amusement park, which they close down in winter time. But the Ferris wheel is running more or less all year round, except for 2 weeks in January. Then it has to go through technical checks, like you have to take your car once a year through a technical check to see if it's safe enough and everything is okay. Yeah, and behind the amusement park, there is the large, large forest area with the sport grounds. Yeah, we have our gigantic soccer stadium down there, a bike racing stadium, public pools, tennis, bowling, a lot of sports can be done here. Or you take your bike, rollerblade, inline skating. So people come to do their sports here every weekend. Yeah, and in the big soccer stadiums, for instance, we have concerts taking place. Yeah. This week, at the weekend tomorrow, yeah, to be precise, they are going to have the Guns N' Roses concert. Can you imagine? Yeah. So, I mean, very, very popular event. Yeah? And finally, down towards the banks of the river, there is the convention center. And we have 3 big convention centers. One is across the Danube River, and 2 are right here. And already in 2014, we overtook cities like London and Paris when it came to the number of conventions.